Welcome to Real Food. Today is all about sauce. What am I talking about? Sauces are liquid or semi-liquid foods devised to make other foods look, smell, and taste better. It can be used for sweet or savory dishes and served hot or cold. Join us today as we make two very different sauces, one sweet and one spicy. First, we'll be making an oven-roasted tomato sauce, followed by a spicy hot sauce. Now, we're talking about a roasted tomato pasta sauce here. This is a delicious dish. You may be growing tomatoes in your garden, and you say, what do I do with all these tomatoes? They keep coming and coming and coming, you know? When do I finally say enough? Well, this is a great way to say enough. If you take some of your tomatoes, and even if they have some blemishes on them, these have some blemishes on them, that's not the end of the world. You trim them off, and what you do is you slice them kind of thin. And then what you do is get your oven around 200 degrees, 225, not too hot, and you place them in the oven and you just let them go. And we let these go for about an hour and a half, 2 hours. They kind of dry up and all of the flavors intensify as the liquid comes out. And you put a little bit of olive oil, a little bit of salt on top, and then you just let these go. That's it. It's that simple. And what happens is you're kind of going to process all of this into a terrific, terrific tomato sauce. This roasted flavor is so strong in there. And what happens from the oven, my mouth is naturally watering talking about it, the tomato flavor just intensifies. And not acidic, but just sweet, sweet, sweet. So that's what we're going to do now. We're going to kind of go to stage two. I've already sliced the tomatoes, and I've already baked them at a low heat for a long time. You probably can't do it long enough. If you did this for 3 or 4 hours, it would be fine. And as the tomatoes dry, they get even more intense, the flavor. So it's really terrific. So I have a blender here. Can you use a food processor? Absolutely, you can do that. I think this is a good one too, just for kids, because I think what happens is sometimes kids sort of get caught up and they get used to one thing and that's all they ever have. Sometimes it's about stretching a little bit. I used to see that in high school. I worked at one of the Catholic high schools for a long time. The kids had hamburgers every day. And I used to like now and then put something else out, you know? In Lent, we used to have rice and beans on a Friday. And boy, oh boy, the kids turned their noses up at it, and they had this sacrificial meal. They got it for a dollar. And the rice and beans were so good, it actually beat what a sacrificial meal is about. It wasn't a sacrifice. The kids absolutely loved it. So sometimes it's about challenging our kids a little bit into eating something a little bit more healthy. The other thing with this sauce, by the way, is it's already cooked, right? Because you cook the tomato. So it doesn't take long to kind of to get this ready to eat. So I don't know how much I'm going to make. We'll see how much I got here. And then I don't want to make too much, but I don't want to make too little either. I want to fill up a big jar today. So I'll put this in. Now, if you notice also, by the way, I'm putting in the seeds, right? Yeah, because the seeds won't be bitter here. Seeds will be perfect. They'll be just fine in here because when we blend it, it'll kind of come down. All right. Let me get some of the boys over here. I want to put just a little bit more in the blender because I want to make a nice batch of this. This is all cooled off, by the way, so I had it, like I said, in the oven for quite a while. But then I just, you know, let it cool off and it's fine because you can cook this again. You can heat it up. It's very, very durable, this stuff, so it's great. These tomatoes are very, very well roasted. They fall apart very easily. It's great. Get a few more of these guys in. Beautiful. All right, that looks like enough. Let me just do this. Okay. Now, what does this go with? It goes with all kinds of great things. Oh boy, you can make this with spaghetti. It goes great with any one of a number of great pastas, but like a spaghetti or a linguine is terrific with this roasted tomato sauce. So let me just get this little piece here that's bothering me in. Okay. Now, a little bit of olive oil in here. So just a little bit, not too crazy, but enough to kind of make it some liquid. I'm going to put some pepperoncino in. Now, when you cook this outside of the jar, of course, you can add more. But I'm going to put a little bit in. This way, we have a little bit of heat. And I'm also going to add a little bit of salt. And again, you could always adjust the salt. So I'm just going to put a little bit in to start. But then when we cook it and put the pasta, then we can actually, we can add to it. All right, so let me get the blender going here, see what we can get cooking. Okay, so now as you see, kind of ready to go. I might even put in a little more tomato, to be honest with you, because I think we have a little room here to grow. Let's see if I can do this. Put a little bit more. Now, it'll also evaporates a lot. So in the oven, a lot of the liquid comes out, and that's why you can kind of make a nice sauce out of this. Maybe a little bit more. Now, I have a big tradition every year. You know, I put up a lot of tomatoes, and I have some guys, believe it or not, from a youth group that I used to have when I was a young priest. Now they're all in their 40s, and they're married, and they have kids. And I get together with these guys, and we put up tomatoes every year. We do about 180 quarts, believe it or not, of tomatoes. So I have these jars that I get, and I use to put up tomatoes. Now, what this is good for is it seals in, but you can boil this jar. And when you put this jar in boiling water for like 45 minutes, it seals, cooks the tomatoes, and you're done with this. It'll keep for years. Can you imagine that? And it's a great tradition, you know. We used to do it at the church, and it was actually like a later youth group activity, believe it or not. And it was a great thing. I think passing some of those traditions on to like our youth ministry and everything is kind of a really fun thing because it talks about family and faith and, you know, how we pass these things on in a family. Roasted tomatoes, this is kind of a foo-foo thing now for like a New York City or depending what city is near the house where you're watching right now, you know, some kind of restaurant, that's where you'd see that. So here we go. We're going to put this in. I'm going to try to be kind of careful if I can, not to overlap the sides, not to squirt myself. That's it. That's pretty good. Just a little bit left for me to have a little lunch. Now, simple enough, we just put the lid on. It has that rubber piece in there. So we put the lid on it. And then on either side, one of these little clips. That's it. It's just very simple. You clip it. And you clip it. And now the only other thing to do here would be to take this jar and to put it in the boiling water if you wanted to seal it. Now the other thing you could do with this if you didn't want to seal it is put this in the fridge. The only thing I would change if I was going to put this in the fridge is I would put a little layer of olive oil on the top. The reason I'd put a little layer of olive oil is because that preserves the tomato. So you just kind of lay it in nice and easily. And you'll see it'll just kind of build up right over the top. Then you can put the jar in the fridge. This will keep indefinitely in the fridge too for quite a while. You want to watch it, of course, because it'll start to darken. The tomatoes will darken a little bit, and some of that air will come out of the tomatoes too. So you have to watch for that. But that's that in a pound of pasta with a family of four is something really be grateful to God for. It's a terrific fresh way to use our tomatoes from our gardens. A lot of times we don't know what to do with them. We slice them, we eat them, we make sandwiches with them. I love all of those things. But this is a way to really do something great with the later tomatoes, you know? Let them roast and make this delicious roast tomato sauce with pasta. Terrific, terrific recipe, and so simple too, right? When we get back, get ready because we're gonna be doing some hot stuff. Stick around.
The Catholic Faith Network Green Room was provided by Lane Office, your workspace built with integrity.
You'd have to say that hot sauce truly is a craze, right? There are stores dedicated to it, different degrees. There's all of this rating system about how hot, you know, the peppers actually are. So what we're going to do today is make a hot sauce. But I have a bunch of different grades of hot peppers. And if you notice, I'm wearing gloves. Whenever you're going to do this, wear gloves, please. Learn from someone who hasn't learned yet. Wear gloves. So I'm going to show you how easy this is to do. It's really a very simple thing, but it could be fun, you know, that you have your own hot sauce that you develop according to your own tastes in your own home. That's a great thing to be able to do. Maybe you use it for wings, maybe you don't use it for wings, but whatever you do, it's great to have a little like hot sauce that you can call your own. So I have a pot here that I'm going to pour about a cup and a half of white wine vinegar in it. So distilled vinegar. Just put that in. This is already pre-measured. Now this is going to be what we're going to cook the peppers in, literally. So I'm going to get that all in. There we go. So that's good. Now, next we go to some garlic. So simple stuff, because we want to give it a little bit of flavor. Now, if you don't like garlic, well, then don't put garlic in your hot sauce. But all of the good hot sauces that are out there, they're all kind of got some garlic in them. And you can go to all kinds of websites to look these up and different ones to get like your favorites. So I'm going to put a bunch of cloves of garlic in so it has nice, strong garlic flavor. That's it. I'm going to just crack them, and in they go. They're going to just go right into the vinegar. So they go in. And we'll begin that process. Now, let me talk to you a little bit about all these peppers. So we have all different grades of hot peppers here. So I have a cheat sheet. I will honestly tell you because I don't remember all of them. So these here are called, these are from Syria. Whoops, not that guy. These are from Syria. They're called Msgr peppers. These are hot. They're not ridiculously hot, but these are definitely hot peppers. The seeds, like I said, are from Syria. These are from Colorado. These are Ahi hot peppers. These are hot. Not ridiculously hot, but hot. Now, when we go to ridiculously hot, These are sriracha peppers. These are ridiculously hot, and they're spicy on a lot of different levels. These are African bird peppers. So again, it's all the different seeds you can get in a seed catalog. You can grow these at home, and they're wonderful. African birds. These are, thanks be to God, our friends, the red hot peppers. These are just the regular peppers that you see with pepperoncino, the regular red hot peppers. This is called the chocolate ghost pepper. Now, the ghost pepper is probably by far the hottest pepper ever created. I tasted a little piece of one of these boys one day, and I would say for about 3.5 hours, my throat was on fire. I mean, on fire. So I'm going to make a hot sauce today, and we're going to use a little piece of the chocolate ghost. Now, you say to yourself, well, why are we doing this? Well, you know, this is part of the way the world was created by God, that there are these different things that are very, very hot, not so hot. They were protective of other things that would grow. So if an animal came and ate this, they'd run, you know, run for the hills. They'd run for the nearest lake and jump in. So that was part of how this all happened naturally. And for us, spice is something that's really a big part of our lives, right? We love spice. So spice is something that's important. And it's particularly hot stuff, right? Some people I know, I remember some Korean priests, friends of mine, they would take me out to a Korean restaurant in Flushing, and the food was so spicy for them. I went easy, but the food was so spicy for them, they'd be sweating, but they'd be laughing and enjoying it all. It wouldn't bother them. Me, the slightest taste of their food, and I was done for the night. You know, it was just too much. I like spicy, but it was just too much spice. So I'm just seeing how far along we are with this. This is coming along. This is good. Just about at a boil. So I'm going to start to work with these peppers. Now, what I basically want to do is I want to trim off the ends. And then you say, well, there's an option with the seeds, right? If you have the seeds, it could be much hotter. If it doesn't have the seeds, it might not be as hot. So I'm going to leave some of the seeds on. Some of the ones I'm going to get rid of the seeds. We'll see. These guys are good. I have these beautiful guys from Syria. You think about how this all developed from all over the world, right? Like even in, you know, parts of the Holy Land, there are hot peppers. There's all these different ways in which we can kind of contact like ancient history, you know? These things have been around. They've developed for years. It's incredible. So this first load here, I'm going to just take in this gloved hand and drop into the vinegar. And you'll see that this vinegar begins to take on a pretty red color pretty fast. Same thing here. Now I'm going to go with these that are not so hot. Thank God. We have a little bit of a balance. Sometimes things are so hot you can't even enjoy them, right? So I think that's something to kind of think about. And I know a lot of people make their own hot sauce and they kind of balance out these peppers. They know, you know, like what ones they like, what ones they can tolerate. For kids, it's hard, right? Spicy food, it's hard to kind of figure out like what works for kids, what doesn't work for kids. You know, I was just with some family that had some kids who love spicy stuff, and they were eating, you know, a lot of spicy food. So I don't know. For me, I just kind of like things medium spicy. Now this, like our ghost pepper, I'm going to take the seeds out because I'm a little worried. I don't want to cause a fire. It's going to be spicy. So take the seeds out for the most part. Drop these in. Now again, this is one of the reasons you wear the gloves, because it's important. Now the ghost pepper, which even I am afraid of, to be honest with you, I'm gonna cut this. This is called the chocolate ghost pepper. I'm gonna cut this, and I'm definitely gonna remove the seeds from this because this is ridiculously hot. And when I say ridiculously hot, like, I know people who can eat these, but I would think it would put you in the hospital if we had this, if we're not used to it. You know, you get a tolerance to heat too. So I'm gonna drop these in. Now, just to help with the flavor, because this is going to be, you know, hot, it's going to be vinegar, it's garlic. Now, I'm also going to put a sweet pepper in there. Why, you say, are you putting a sweet pepper in? Well, it's going to give some nice color, but it's also going to help flavor it. Like, they don't call them sweet peppers for nothing, you know? And I think we need that. I think we need to have a little bit of sweet just to offset it. So sweet red is wonderful. Put this in there, too. Get the seeds out of that, because seeds don't really benefit you in the red pepper. Nothing we can, sweet red pepper. So I'll put these all in. And then the only other thing I want to add is a little bit of salt. Now, it definitely doesn't need pepper, right? But it, just a little bit of salt. So I'll put these in. And then I'm going to put a little bit of salt in. Just like a teaspoon. Now, the only thing to do with this now is to stir it. And you have to even be careful. I know I'm talking like we're dealing with like some kind of explosive material, but you have to be careful in stirring this too, because if you splash this and you get it on you, it's going to burn. And even if you get it on your face or something, it's going to burn. So, like, if you get this on your hand and you rub your eye, you're going to have some serious pain, you know? So now you might be saying to yourself, well, why are you making this, Monsignor? But I think this is kind of fun. Like, you know, sometimes it's fun to do things that we actually... Now I have to move because it makes me cough. It's fun to do things that other people can participate in, but also that we can gift to other people. I make a number of things at home that I like to gift to other people. I make sauce, of course, that I jar, and I'm glad to be able to bring that to people's house. I make limoncello, you know, that liqueur, the Italian liqueur. I make that too, because again, that's something fun to bring to somebody's house and offer it to them. You know, that's a great gift. And I also make the hot pepper. Now, I don't use all these different hot peppers. I usually just use red jalapenos, and that's it. But if you, you know, use all these different hot peppers, you make a special hot pepper sauce. There's kind of something fun about that too. So I think sometimes it's fun to jar things. I know people who make chocolate. All of those things, I think, a way we can take the gifts God's given us, you know, and bring them to somebody's place, bring them to somebody's house. It's a great dinner gift, you know, to be able to do, to bring it to somebody's place and recognize, you know, what this is all about and kind of share with them. So what we're doing here is we're not only steeping, I could barely breathe this. We're not only steeping these peppers, but we're cooking them. And we're cooking them in this vinegar, salt, and garlic. That's kind of how it goes. And they're kind of coming down already. They're already starting to cook. And it's boiling up. Ooh, very, 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 very strong. And what we're going to do then afterwards, I'll just fast forward the process a little bit. What we're going to do is we're going to put it in a blender, and then we're going to blend this all down. And then you can put it in a bottle and keep it in the fridge. It'll stay for quite a while, because when you think about it, vinegar is a naturally preserving agent. So that's going to naturally preserve this. I mean, when we pickle things, you know, that's we put them in vinegar. So that's exactly what we're going to do here. We're actually pickling these peppers, and we're going to boil them down. Then we're going to blend them up. Then we can put them in a jar, and they'll stick around in the fridge for months. And you'll be able to use them on stuff. And again, what does it go on? It goes on grilled stuff. It goes on chicken. It goes on wings, of course. If you're having a party where you're going to serve wings, you know, you have your own hot sauce, right? All right, well, this is just about boiled to a perfection now. It's just about where it needs to be. Now, I also want to thank, by the way, Don, who is the farmer at Homecoming Farms, because he grew all of these hot peppers and gives them to me and explains them to me. It's so great to belong to a community farm. It puts you in touch, I think, with nature and our environment. And they're so spiritual there. You know, they pray the rosary there all the time in the garden. It's beautiful. I love going there. A lot of Saturdays, that's where you'll find me. So anyway, I'm going to put these in. I am so afraid of this that I'm going to just use this ladle. I don't want to get any of this on me. So I'm just going to put this into the blender. And you could, this is an unbelievable aroma. The steam alone could force peace in the world. I'm telling you right now, it's that hot. It's incredible. My eyes are watering already just from experiencing this for a second. Okay? A little bit more. It's kind of fun to do at home, though, right? You certainly don't have to use the hottest peppers on earth. But it's certainly fun to do at home. Now I'm going to do this. Okay, that got all the peppers in. Ladle, metal, it'll clean up, it'll be okay. That's the promise. Now we'll just take this and get the garlic in. There it is. Okay, everything's in. So now, you want a tight-fitting lid. I guess you know why, right? So we put the tight-fitting lid on, and we're just going to go with a stir. But you do want to break up the seeds, too, so we're going to let it go a little bit. And then I'm going to move it up. All right. Now, it looks like a hot sauce, doesn't it? Because it really is. So look at that nice smoke there. It's like we're doing the Munsters, huh? So here we are. Now, what I am going to do now is I'm going to give it a little taste. And I am as nervous as anybody here, but I'm going to give it a little bit of a taste because I just want to see the heat level and what I got to work with here. So I have a teaspoon here. I'm just going to go a tiny bit in here. Look how much I have on there. Not even that much, I don't think. There it is. Yes. And it is ridiculously hot, but it's delicious. It's vinegary. It has a little salt. And the different kinds of heat that are in there are awesome. There's a hit when you first take it, There's a hit afterwards, and now I have this lasting glow. I have to tell you another thing. It's not impossible. This is something you could eat. It's not so hot you couldn't even enjoy it. So it's kind of a fun sauce and worth, you know, worth trying with your friends. And this would be great. I'll tell you the truth. This would be great on chicken. Awesome on chicken. It's got a great, great flavor. And it's really very flavorful. And the heat is like a punch, and then it kind of fades away. That's the way you want to do it. All right, I'm going to put it in a jar for you and everything. When we get back, you'll see it all jarred up. We'll see you in a minute. Today was all sauce. We made oven-roasted tomato sauce and also a spicy hot sauce. For the recipes, we used fresh vegetables, tomatoes and peppers, and they're companion plants, meaning that they can be grown together and can easily be maintained in your own home garden. It may take time before your efforts in the garden are visible. I know that's like that with me all the time, but that's true of our prayer lives too. It takes effort and a lot of dedication. The transformation of a person who immerses himself or herself in prayer takes time too. It's important to have patience, even when life gets in our way. Saint Monica is a model of patience who never gave up hope and her faith in God among all the tribulations of her family life and being the mother of Saint Augustine. We look to her to help us live more faithfully, dedicated, and of course, with a little more patience. And so joining me now in a prayer for patience. God of grace, you make me softer, kinder, gentler, generous, forgiving, and loving. Yet at times I know these gifts wear thin. I feel impatience rising, I sense resentment brooding, and revenge is on my lips. So I pray today and all days for more of your spirit. May the grace that you pour out open the door for a renewing of my mind, a restoration of my heart, and a transformation of my soul. Thank you that in you I find new strength, discover more patience, and walk with grace at work in my life. Amen. Well, thanks for joining us today. For a copy of these recipes, you can visit our website at cfntv.org or email us at realfood@cfntv.org. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you next time on Real Food.
Real Food Set and Appliances has been provided by Chufo Cabinetry, a family tradition of fine woodworking since 1907. Chufo Cabinetry has been filling the custom cabinetry needs of the New York tri-state area for over 100 years. By combining old-world techniques with modern technology to provide the finest custom kitchens and millwork. Luxury appliance innovators Sub-Zero, Wolf, and Cove. Cosentino, a Spanish company world leader in the production and distribution of innovative surfaces for architecture and design. Silestone, Decton, and Sensa by Cosentino, technologically advanced surfaces that allow the creation of unique designs for the home and public spaces. Blackman Plumbing Supply. Visit a Blackman showroom today and let their specially trained design consultants help you find the luxury plumbing, tile, lighting, and stone products you need to make your project a success. Top Knobs, the designer's choice.